In today's video, we're going to show how to make chainmail out of green stuff, which is perfect for adding extra customised details to your characters. Now, the first thing we need to do is get some tools together, and as you can see here, I've got a pot of water, which is ideal because I'll need that to keep my fingers wet, especially when mixing the green stuff. We've got some green stuff itself, I've got a modelling knife to cut the green stuff out with, I've got a paperclip, which is going to be my tool for doing the design of the chainmail, and I've got a modelling file, which is there just to file off the edges of the paperclip, just to make it a little bit easy to work with. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut out some green stuff. So all I need to do is get a little strip like I've got here. Now you do get a little bit of plastic film, so I'm just going to peel that back. And all we're going to do now is take the lid off our knife, and I'm just going to cut a little slice of the yellow and the blue. Now all you need to do is just cut along, try and get an equal amount of each of them. Now the other thing you'll need to do, I always like to do, is I tend to, or you'll find, that you've got actually, where they're two touching, the blue and the yellow touching, they've actually started to cure, so it's actually a good idea if you just cut those out, because if you don't, you might get some lumpy bits actually in your green stuff, and it will just be really hard to mix. So what I'm going to do is just cut those out, like so. And then with all those cut out like that, we're just going to start mixing them together. So if I just pull that up like so, all I'm going to do is just keep twisting it. It's going to add some water to my fingers as well. And we'll just keep twisting that around, roll it in the palm of your hand as well, just so it, you're looking for something like Warboss Green or Scarsnet Green when you actually start mixing it. That's the kind of colour you're aiming for. So just keep mixing it till it looks green. And there we are with the green stuff now mixed. I've left this to cure for about 30 minutes, which is about the perfect amount of time to start working with. Now, if you don't leave it too long, it's still quite soft and pliable. Now, I've got a model I actually started doing the chainmail on yesterday, and I'd left it too early, so it was still quite wet. And to start off with, the design was working quite well, but as I got further down, the actual material started to move around, which then made it look a lot soft, and it just started to stretch and didn't work as well. So leaving it for around about 30 minutes is perfect. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make the tool. So I'm just going to get the paper clip. Now all I need to do is just straighten one side out like so. So all we're going to do is just get that one side there straightened up. It doesn't have to be perfectly straight. And then I'm going to get my modelling file, and just at the top here, just where the actual top of the clip is, I'm just going to start rounding that off with a file, so you don't have to go too mad, just so it's not too harsh and sharp. This will just make your tool a lot easier to work with when you start doing the indentations. With our paperclip now filed down, it's ready to be used as the tool. So what I'm going to do now is just get some of this green stuff. You can see on the ball, I'm just going to pinch a little bit off, so it's probably like a sixth of the ball I've made, like so, and then all I'm going to do is just straighten out a little bit. It's kind of like a weird like little bit of tablet or whatever. Now I'm just going to fold that around the actual model. So what I'm going to do is just where the model is, just place that down like so. And then I'm just going to add a little bit of water in my finger so it's easy to work with. And just around the front here, I'm just going to use my knife just to slice some of this off as well. So you've got to be super careful when doing this, because obviously we want this to look like a skirt, not just some random thing hanging on it. So I'm just going to use that there like so. And then we're then ready to start making the chainmail design. So what I'm going to do, when doing this design, I start from the top and then I work down. So all you're going to be doing is adding little dots. So you place one dot in, like so, and then almost identically next to it, you place another dot. And what this does is it pushes the wall slightly into the previous dot. So all you just keep doing that, you just keep moving along the top like so. You can see it's making like little dots. You work all the way along. And then what we're going to do is I'm just going to flip them upside down. Then we're going to work the opposite way. So, but you don't do it straight underneath. You're going to do it just offset. So we'll do the same thing, but working the other way. I'm just going to keep pushing in, and what you start to get is like almost links, just like chainmail. Just keep doing that. If you do struggle and you get it wrong a couple of times, just take the green stuff off, re-roll it, and just keep working back. And obviously you just keep doing this, so you work one way on one line, work the opposite way on the next line, and just keep doing that till you get to the bottom. And there we are, the chainmail design is now done on the little bit of skirt I did on this Blood Reaver. Now I've got another Blood Reaver I did earlier, so this is another chainmail skirt on this guy. Also, when it hardened down a bit, I just used a knife and just gently cut around the bottom just to give it a bit more shape in. And I've also got a traitor guardsman here as well, where I just did a little chainmail mask across his face. Now, obviously when doing any green stuff and then you're using a knife, just be super careful. And if you're still quite young, try and get a parent to do it as well. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy making your own chainmail designs, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.